Yeah, welcome to Dragon Project. And today I want to go over the limit breaking system bit and also some new events which are released right now. And maybe I will also talk about some quick tips about how you can progress and what to focus on this game and to progress fast and without much problems, without many problems, so that you have it easier for your grinding and for doing the events and yeah, getting the most out of it. So I hope it helps. And if you didn't so far, you can also check my other video. I think it's called A Dragon Project Tips on How to Fight Behemoths Efficiently, where I give you some tips what to do to fight the behemoths and what you need to consider to be better on it. Yeah, for limit breaking, you may wonder what this even is. You may not have seen it so far as a beginner, but limit breaking is quite essential in this game, and you can go to armory, to the section armory, and when you see your parts you have equipped. And from there, you have a really good way to craft and enhance your equipment even further. You have different possibilities to do this. You can click on the equipment parts and then click enhance. And from there, you can enhance your stuff. And on the right bottom corner, you see this little button, limit break. And you can click on it, and when you see what you can do. And here it says def plus 13, then def plus 24, def 36, and at the end, you see the description, extra enhanced ability magic slot or magi slot. I'm not sure how it's pronounced. I think I will call it magi slot. And on the bottom here you see what you need, but this is a bit misleading because you only need one like this. So for instance, you need to get the Armor Arc Lapis, but the rainbow version. So we have two different kind of versions, the rainbow lapis and the normal lapis. So you need for each equipment which you get from the summoning, you need a rainbow lapis, but you can also get other lapis versions or equipment you can forge by doing grinding and monsters which were not summoned. So this is important, and you can decide to do this one, Armor Arc Lapis, Rainbow Arc Lapis, or Rainbow High Lapis, or Rainbow Lapis. So if you decide to go for this route, for the A version, you need 31. So And where do you get them? So this is not explained right here. You may get information from there. What is limit break? Sometimes it helps. And we take a quick look if it can really help us. And yeah. Let's see. Not that much. On the bottom, you can it says you can perform limit break on equipment by consuming rainbow lapis and lapis. These materials can be obtained by selling behemoth tablets and certain equipment. So this is already a hint what you can do. You can sell Behemoth tablets you get from the fights. You may get from the fights. And you can also sell equipment. So let's show you how this works. So we get go to our main interface, and then we go to Forge, and from there you can sell your different stuff. And for this part we have we need to focus here on the material tab and the equipment tab. Because it said you can sell the tablets and the equipment. So we can try it out. And okay, let's see. Maybe it works for the C. But no, it doesn't work. It only shows it's selling for gold. So we click on something else, and here you see you get a rainbow lapis, the A version. So you could theoretically sell this equipment, and then you get a lapis and you get gold from it. You will always get only one lapis, I think. For obviously for the A equipment you get the A lapis, for S you get the S lapis, and for the SS you get the SS lapis. And now you wonder where you can sell the tablets. You can sell them here at the materials, and to make it easier you simply make a search and only select tablet, and then you do the search and then you see all your tablets. So now you can try to sell it, but at first I was irritated because I did not see what it sells for. So this bit, yeah, misleading. So if you click on done, then you see what you will get, what lapis you will get. So for B you get the tablet, you get the lapis as B. So it works the same as the equipment. But you don't need to forge the equipment. So let's talk about the difference and the advantages and disadvantages on selling the tablets and the equipment you can forge. So the advantage to forge the equipment is that you will get stats from it. So random stats. And if you want to have a kind of equipment, let's say you want to have a new helmet, then you click here on abilities, and then you will see what abilities it has. So for instance, it has great damage, water damage, lightning damage, and so on. And you want, for instance, great damage. Great damage is good for the sword, for the great sword. So you definitely want to get it, and maybe something else which is good, like water damage. Okay. So what you can do is forge. We are not doing this right now because we are low on this one, this headgear crystal. And when you forge it, then you can get random stats on it. And it is not that expensive, especially for A equipment. You see, for S equipment it's more expensive. And but if you craft A equipment, I recommend to do this method, to forge at first your equipment as A. And when you see that this stats are not good enough, when it's crap, you got random crap stats, you can sell them for the lapis, okay? What to talk also is the negative side of it, because you will need this one, the crystal. And the crystals are not always that easy to get. But there is a method right now for me, which works quite well. And this is, you can use the current expedition mode and look for the spots where you can get the, where you can grind and farm the plants and the how it's called. I must take a look right now how it's called. Yeah, the ore spots, and there you can get the crystals also. But it's random, it's based on luck, and but if you do it enough, then you will get them. So this is a good way to get them easily and don't buy them from the other store, which is quite expensive to do so. So if you really don't want to do this, you can only fight the behemoths, get the tablets, and then you can sell the tablets. So this is the easier one. But yeah, like I said, I recommend to get good stats in your equipment to be better prepared to put out more damage and stuff. So we will go back, and now we will give you a an example on how it looks like to have a fully limit broken equipment. So this is fully limit broken, and we used this is the A equipment, and we used 4 lapis for this. So we have all ticked, all selected, and we got at the bottom, here you can see, an extra enhanced ability magi slot. And this is really great, because you can put in then another magi, and let's see what we got. We got Sportcraft. We got 2x Sportcraft, and it gives a whopping 85 attack. So this is really great to boost your overall stats with just limit breaking your A equipment. And this A equipment is not that bad, actually. For instance, this one, it gives fully enhanced and limit broken 83 death, 10 attack, and 30 HP. That is definitely okay for an A equipment, and SS is maybe something like 100 death and 20 attack and 30 HP, I've seen. So this is not that bad, actually. So you can be probably equipped with A equipment, and this is okay right now. This is the easy the easy part for getting equipment. Quite fast, reliable equipment which can carry you through the game. So for this one, for instance, I did it not so far, but because I was lazy, but I will do it later on. And if you have a good A weapon, I did not focus on this so far, you can try to also limit break it, because it will give you also an extra magi slot. But be careful, always read this line on the bottom, what it says. Here it says it's an attack magi slot, but it can also be, let's give you an example, an extra support magi slot right here. So this is what you can't decide for. it is fixed and you can't change this, so yeah, you need to know this, you need to keep this in mind. And this one, I think I've heard extra support mics that can be really beneficial, for instance for XP farming or mobs or grinding mobs. It's really beneficial to have two healing magi slots, because that way you have it much easier to survive in fights and load up the bars of your magi slots. But right now it's only quite easy for the A weapon, maybe for S weapon it's also possible. For instance, the spear, the fire spear, S version is really good, and I've already seen some which were limit broken. So this is what you could, what you can do. But I think you should try to do at first the A equipment and get the magi slots open. But it's also important to have the right magi, so it doesn't help you much if you don't have the magi to equip. So that is why I always recommend to summon on the magi if you have enough equipment. And for the most of the time you will have enough equipment. You will get very many A behemoths you can fight. And that is why, and you will also get tickets, so you will summon anyway. And that is why I recommend you to get enough magi at first to place them in your equipment. So you have for each equipment part a good magi equipped. So I hope this time is still enough for me to do a magi summon. I don't summon on the behemoth right now, because like I said, magi is really important and I still need some. So we go to the summon section. We will focus, or we will look on the behemoths another time, maybe in another video. So let's hope that this guy, I'm not sure how he's called, maybe we should address him with a name to be polite. And yeah, let's hope for the best and get. I need still a good defense magi. So this is what I'm hoping for. Okay, let's see. So we need at least S magi. Okay, nice. 2, 3. Okay, let's see. Come on. Oh. Come on. An SS, nice. Okay. And the Iron Wall Mastery, this is what I'm talking about. This is exactly the one I needed. That is really, 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 really great. That was a great summoning, because we got an Iron Wall Mastery, which you carry through the game. Because the higher defense, the lower damage you will get from the annoying behemoths and monsters. And maybe I will show you next time how I can maybe grind this annoying level 80 monsters. because I want to have more XP, and they are still kinda able to kill me sometimes. So I hope this Magi will carry me, and it's also great that I got this version here. We got a lightning damage, Thunder Blade. I have not any good Thunder weapon right now, but in the future we will get one, I think. So for this part, I think I have maybe already enough Magi. So that is why I may try to put my gems for the future into the Behemoth. But yeah, still, Magi are very, very good. And you even can enhance them furthermore. If there are some Magi types, like Attack Magi or Heal Magi, which you can enhance when they are max level. And this, I think, I did not really understand this, but I think it says it reduces the charge time. And that way I think you will get the Magi ready more often. So for each enhancement, plus one is 2% less charge time. So this is really great, and that is why I think Magi summoning is so important, and we should definitely try to focus on this. And to also make sure to get this, at least one of this Iron Wall Mastery or this Vitality S version, because it's so important to have high defense and high HP. Okay, I am quite happy with this summoning. I've got nearly everything I wanted right now. And I wish you also great luck for your summoning and for your grinding. And I hope that these tips will help you. So thank you for watching. And if you really like my simple but maybe still helpful tips, videos and introductions and overviews of this game, then yeah, just like it. And if you like, you can also subscribe to my channel. I will try to put out more videos about this game and maybe some others I play. But yeah, for this part I'm finished, and yeah, we will see you soon again. I will see you soon again. Okay, have a good time, have a good day.